How's it going, everybody? Cub Fan here, and today is episode 95 of Cub Fan's Minecraft Let's Play. And yeah, guys, so since last time, I went ahead and added on a little bit to our storage system. I added seeds here to our storage system, and you see we got a little over a chest here. We got over two chests of cobblestone, and then some each of dirt, gravel, and netherrack. And as I said before, I'll be adding on to this sorting system as time goes on. That's that. This episode will be a shorter one because I've been kind of busy the last week or so, but still we're gonna do some pretty cool stuff. So first of all, we're gonna need to find some wood. Let's see here. Jungle wood. Well, I keep the wood over here. Yeah, oak wood. All right, and we'll craft up some fences. We'll get some sticks and we'll make a bunch of fences here. And what I want to do here is I want to make a timer for horses so I could test how fast each horse is and then see which ones are the fastest. So we'll make like a little mini race course thing. And we'll also make like a field for the horses too. So let's actually get a lot more fence here. Yeah, let's just make all this into wood. And the stable is right here. As I said before, I want to expand this and essentially double the size of it. So we got some horses in here now. There's our main horse, Xanthos. Got the wheat storage here, so I want this to be basically the midpoint. So I'll continue it out here, and that means we'll have to have some type of fence out this way. I should probably clear a little bit of land here. I'll go ahead and chop down some of these trees. I will probably make this lake a little bit smaller and possibly do some terraforming in this region here with this big hill. Because it'd be nice to clear this and then have like a sort of like a straight shot out from the stable to have like a field area here. So I'll get to work on that. Yeah, let's see. We'll probably want it to be. Yeah, we can have them lead it up a little bit here, but yeah, I'll go ahead and clear some of this out here and I'll be back. Okay, everybody, so right next to the stable, cleared a bunch of land out, made a bunch of these lakes a little bit smaller, cleared out a lot of trees, kept some of the trees that are three high, but the ones that are too high, I didn't want because it was ruining the look of the area. Made this lake a lot smaller and got rid of the tree there, and I'm hoping that the horses will roam around in this area here. That would be quite nice, in my opinion. So let's see where we want to put down this fence at. Let's see. So I think we're going to go around the outside here. So we'll probably start it a bit out from where this path is. So maybe somewhere in here. And then have it go along this way. To around here, up on this edge here, then up on this hill, and then over, and then sort of follow that arc shape behind some of these trees for the rest of it. But it looks like it's getting dark now, so I'll go ahead and sleep through the night, and I'll be back out once we're ready to lay down this fence. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and put down our fence gates here. We'll have four fence gates there, and then fence all the way around. I did craft up some more fence from the wood we got, and we'll just make the start of this area here. I'll have it go up this way a little ways and turn this way. All right, and as I am laying down this fence, I just want to say a big thank you to all my subscribers. We just recently passed 1,500 subscribers as a channel, So I just wanted to say thank you to all of you who are subscribed to me. It means a lot to me, and I just want to say thank you very much. Also, I want to announce officially now that I will be doing a Let's Play on the PlayStation 3 of The Last of Us. That'll be the first series on PlayStation. That'll probably be within a few weeks, probably just a week or two, actually. So look forward to that. So there'll be different games now on the channel, not just Minecraft. But I'm by no means stopping Minecraft. Probably always continue to play Minecraft in some facet on the channel, but it's good to play other games too. And we're going to be playing The Last of Us for a while. And then, of course, we'll be playing, as I mentioned before, Grand Theft Auto 5 for sure. I can also do other games if it's demanded. For example, Saints Row, Uncharted, anything like that I could also do. So we'll see how that goes. Let's see, we're getting some good progress here on the fence. Let's see here. We'll probably make it go out here around this tree, and then circle back around like that. Yeah, I think that'll be a good area for the horses to roam around in. So yeah, I'll just continue to build up this fence. Alright everybody, just finishing up the fence here. We got a pretty decently sized area, I feel. We're going to be playing PlayStation 3 games, so if you want to see any particular game, feel free to suggest it to me, and I may play it. We're also, I'm also trying to get a good channel, a good channel intro, and a nice channel art. I've recently changed both of those, so let me know what you think about those. So a lot of changes come to the channel relatively soon. I'm also looking into getting a partnership. So that's another thing that we can look forward to. And yeah, let's go ahead and finish this up before the sun goes down. Just got a little ways to go here. Looks like there's a cow gonna be fenced in here. But that's alright. Alright, there we go. Got our fences up. And yeah, I think that's a pretty sizable area, so we can keep a bunch of horses in there. And yeah, let's see what else we're gonna do this episode. Okay, everybody, so we got our fence up over there. You can see it through the window a little bit. So that's where we're going to keep our horses, but now we need to make the mechanism that we can use to test exactly how fast they're going to be. And to do that, we're going to need some pistons. I already got like a redstone block, some repeaters, some redstone, some trip wires. We'll need some string, I think. Just a little bit of string. And what else? We'll need a dropper, so we'll make that. Need a dropper, okay. And let's see, we'll need like a chest. Let's see, got plenty of those. Wow, we got a lot of chests. All right, chest, and I think that's basically it. We got some pressure plates. I'll get a few more pressure plates just in case. Whoop, not like that. There we go, like that. All right. We'll go ahead and first place some pressure plates down here, so that way we can easily get in to see our horses. And we'll leave them like that so we can get out easily. But yeah, once I make this bigger, this will be twice as large, so the other end of the stable will be down this way. So I think what we're going to do is we're going to have a horse preserve there. and have it stay primarily in the swamp biome with the grass and everything. Might expand it a little bit once we get the second half here and once we get more horses. But I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to build a testing facility in the desert over here. And I can build like a little bridge over over this way to reach this upper plateau here. But we'll have our testing facility over here somewhere. Yeah, so I think right around here would probably be ideal for this testing facility. What's this? Okay. That was a strange noise. What is that? I don't think I've ever seen this before. This is weird. Yeah. I'm just gonna go ahead and go back out. It sounds like a zombie, but... Oh, it's a little mini zombie. Ha! Mini zombie! What the heck? I didn't know those guys could even spawn in that game. Wow. Oh, he's fast. Oh my god, he's fast. Wow. Little mini baby zombie. That's pretty cool. I guess they can now spawn in 1.6.2. Huh. Okay. Anyway, we'll go ahead and make our testing facility here. There'll be a bridge over here eventually. And we'll make it... I think we'll probably just make it right here. And let's see. We're going to go ahead and... I'll go ahead and clear out a 50 block long area here. We'll make it 50 blocks long and 3 blocks wide. Alright, everybody. So, we have our track here. And I'm going to go ahead and place down some green wool here, indicating that this is where we will start. And then way down here at the end... Let me get out an ender pearl. Down here at the end, we'll go ahead and put 2 pieces of red wool, and that will be where we will stop at. We'll go ahead and put some pressure plates down, and also some black wool here. Just like that. Pressure plates on those. And we'll pearl down there. Perfect. And we will go ahead and, yeah, we'll put some black wool down there and some pressure plates down there. So the idea is once we hit this pressure plate, a timer will start and it won't stop until we cross the other pressure plates down at the other end. So how we're going to do this, we're going to dig down here. Dig out this area, and we can go ahead and put down cobblestone if we want to. We'll get our redstone out. Take our redstone out like this. Out like that. And then out around the side here. Alright. And let's see, we're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6... 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. And on the 15th one, we'll put a repeater. Then we'll come down to the opposite side. Do the same thing there. Okay, everybody, so I just did the same thing down at the end here as I did before. With the repeater there, and then on both lines, I went ahead and extended the redstone signal more with redstone. So we have a 4-block gap here. We'll go ahead and place a piston down there and a piston down there. Then we'll go ahead and take a block of redstone there, piece of redstone there. And I was going to do this with a dropper, but now I think the hopper would probably be easier because it doesn't require a clock. So we'll put a hopper facing into that block there. We'll get rid of that, and we'll place a chest down. And we'll place some blocks in the hopper, 64 blocks. So now, let me just show you how this works. We'll go ahead and run the course and time ourselves. So we run over it, over these pressure plates. The block of redstone, as you can see, has moved over. So the hopper is now outputting items into the chest. And once we get to the end here, it moves back. Hopper's disabled again. And it looks like we got 23 cobblestone in there. And so that way we can compare our horses. So yeah, good stuff. So let's go ahead and get one of our horses and we will try this out. Teleport over there. Get into the stable. Alright. Let's see, I think we have a saddle on Xanthos. Yep. Alright, so let's ride him. That'll be the first one we tried out on. Let's see, I think we can make it over here. Yeah, nice. Okay. So we'll move over here, get in position. 3, 2, 1. There we go. Alright, let's see what we got here. 12. Okay. Let's go ahead and put those back in there. And we'll try it one more time just to verify the validity of the test. So here we go. 3, 2, 1. Alright. And we should get like 11, 12, or 13. Yep, 12 again. Okay, that's good news. Try it once more. Here we go. Alright, block moves over. Block snaps. And let's see. 12 a third time. So yeah, it's pretty consistent. So yeah, good stuff there. And let me see if we can convert this to a speed. Okay, everybody, so to calculate the speed, here's what we're going to do. I tested in the creative world and checked on the wiki. And stop it. And it turns out that the hoppers output blocks at a rate of 0.4 seconds per block. And I verified that in my creative world as well. So 0.4 seconds per block, and we had 12 blocks with Xanthos. So multiply those together, you get 4.88 seconds for Xanthos to run from the start to the finish. And we know the distance that he ran in that time, which is 50 meters, the length of this track here. So that equals a total speed of 10.4 meters per second. So I'm probably going to do that with every horse here. Let me just go ahead and put him back in the stable, and we'll try some other horses here. Okay, everybody, so now we're going to test out this brown horse with the blonde hair, this guy here. So I've also put down wool every 5 meters, so it alternates between black and white, so that gives us a better indication of how fast we're going. So here we go, let's test this one out. Alright, 12, so that's the same speed as the first horse we tested, Xanthos. Alright, next up we're going to test the dark brown horse with the white legs. So here we go. That one seemed a little bit slower. I'm guessing we got about 15 probably. Oh, what's up? 15. Alright, we'll see how fast that is. So 15 blocks correlates to a speed of about 8.3 meters per second. So this horse is a little bit slower than the other two we've tested thus far. Okay, next up we're going to go ahead and test the black horse, and it seems like this guy might actually be the fastest. But we will see here in just a second. 3, 2, 1, here we go. Oh yeah, I think this guy is going to be the fastest one yet. Let's see what we got here. 11. Yeah, so let's see how fast that is. So 11 blocks correlates to a speed of about 11.4 meters per second, so a little bit quicker than Xanthos and the light brown horse. So this is actually our fastest horse so far. So we'll put him back in here. Come on back, buddy. And we'll try the donkey. Oh, my bad. Sorry, dude. Darn it. Don't leave. There we go. Alright, we'll try the donkey. And I think, obviously, this is going to be the slowest one, but we'll see how slow. Alright, donkey test in 3, 2, 1. Here we go. I'm guessing we're probably going to get somewhere around 18, but might be faster than that. Who knows? Let's take a look here. 18. Wow, right on the money again. Alright, let's see what speed that correlates to. Alright, so the donkey speed is about 6.9 meters per second, and I'm wondering, let me try and get this guy tied up here, but I'm wondering if we can go faster than the donkey can. I'm guessing we probably can, but let's test just to be sure. So let's see here. We start here. Start going. We double jump. I think we're probably going to be right around the same time as the donkey had. Alright. Let's see what we got here. 19. Yeah, so we're just about as fast as the donkey is. Alright, good to know. Glad we got this up and running. And now, let's go ahead and head back, and I'm actually going to put signs up in the stable to tell me which ones are the fastest and how fast they are. Alright everybody, and since we're testing horse speed here, I also went ahead and built a jump testing facility here. All horses can jump one block, so that one's not needed. But I have 1.5 blocks, 2 blocks, 2.5 blocks, 3 blocks, all the way up to 5 blocks, and I don't think any horses can jump over 5 blocks, but if we do find one, then we'll just have to build another platform. But let's go ahead and test how high this donkey can jump and all the other horses, and then we'll summarize the results at the end here. So the donkey can jump 1.5, but cannot jump 2, it looks like. Yep, donkey can only jump 1.5 blocks. Alright everyone, so after the jump test, this is what we came to for our final conclusion. So the black horse is probably our best horse, this dark black horse. Top speed is the highest, and it has a jump height of 3 blocks. Xanthos is pretty decent. Top speed, 10.6 meters per second, jump height of 2 blocks. This light brown horse is the highest jumper we have. Can jump 3.5 blocks and has a speed of 10.6 meters per second. This one here, 8.3 meters per second, 2.5 meter block height, and the donkey is the slowest and can jump the least, with a speed of 6.9 meters per second and a jump height of 1.5 blocks. Cow, sorry, you're out. So what we're going to do now, we're just going to breed the black, I think we should probably breed the black horse with probably this one here, the high jumper, this guy, and hopefully that offspring will be both fast and able to jump really, really high. So we'll go ahead and go inside. And we'll craft some golden carrots up. You can now only breed horses with golden apples and golden carrots, but golden apples are 8 times more expensive than golden carrots are, so you always want to craft golden carrots if you can. So we'll do that here. Get one. And might as well just make those all into nuggets. And make a bunch of golden carrots here. There we go. Alright, let me get some leads here. I think we have a few here. Yeah, alright. And it looks like it's dark outside, so I'll go ahead and head upstairs on the elevator. Sleep through the night, and I'll be back. Okay, so we got our leads here. We'll lead both of these horses out of their stables. You come with me. And we'll get this guy as well. Come with me. And we'll lead these guys into the field. There we go. Click them both. And all we gotta do is make them breed. And this should give us a little baby horse. There we go. A little baby black horse. Good stuff. Alright, so we'll let this guy grow up and we'll see what he turns into. And we'll speed it up a little bit by giving him a few golden carrots. Yeah. And while we're waiting on that guy to grow up, I'm going to go ahead and we'll craft some hay blocks up. And the cool thing now is that in 1.6.2 you can recraft the hay bales back into wheat. So you can use it as food to breed horses as if you bring us along with you. Or to feed horses if you bring it along with you. So that's a good thing. And we'll come out here and we'll do just that. We'll feed some hay to this guy. Make him grow a little quicker. Alright, convert a few of these back into wheat until he's big. Oh, he's huge. I have a feeling this guy's going to be really fast. Alright, let's tame him here. Let's get this out of our inventory. Oh yeah, this guy's going to be fast. Alright, got him tamed. Let's get a saddle here. Let's see, which horse did we leave it on? I think we left it on the black one down here. Yeah. Whoop. There we go. Alright. Let's put it on him. And let's go test him out, see how quick he is. Alright, let's see. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Alright. Let's see how we did. 12, so 10.6 meters per second on that. Let's do the jump. Easily made the 1.5. Easily made the 2.5, yep. Let's try 3. Oh, that was a bad jump there. 3, yep. 3.5. Not quite. If we can get the max, we can get up probably. There it is, max. Nope. Looks like just 3. So not too bad. Pretty decent horse there. And yeah, we'll continue to breed horses and get more of them. And also name some of them as well. So we'll get off of him. Get the lead out and tie him up. We'll tie him up to that side. Okay. And then we'll go ahead and put down some hay bales. Some of them in like that and close that up. Get our stockpile built up some more. down the correct way. There we go. All right. Good stuff. All right, so we got the field where we can keep a lot of horses. Got some statistics on the horses nailed down. And so I think I'm going to call that an episode, guys. So I'm going to grab some supplies and head down to the mineshaft, and we'll see what today's highlighted channel is. Okay, everybody, down here in the mineshaft now. Today's highlighted channel is 111 Funny Video. So a little bit about Funny Video's channel. He does like vlogs and different things like that, but he also has some pretty decent Lego stop motion animation. So there will be a link in the description to check out his channel. And Funny Video, this is your mineshaft. Let's see how you do against the other competitors. Okay, everybody, and we got the following resources from digging out Funny Video's mineshaft. And if you guys don't recall or didn't see the episode, this is the point system that I use to calculate the total points. So I will do that for this inventory, and I will be back. Okay, everybody, Funny Video coming in today with 2,906 points, and that's good for first place currently. And he's also currently in second place on the Fortune 3 leaderboard. So congratulations to him. Very good mineshaft today. So I'm pretty happy about that. And yeah, guys, episode 95 is this episode. So there will be a world download in the description for those of you interested. I'm just going to make a few small minor changes around here. And then I'll put up the download link. Just clean a few things up. But once again, thank you all for the support. And I'm looking forward a lot to the PlayStation 3 series, The Last of Us, and also other series which you guys might suggest. So, thank you all for watching. This has been CubFan. Goodbye.